All right, what's going on, guys? We got kind of an unexpected throwback for today. It's kind of insane, actually. I'm sure some of you will remember this guy. I made a couple of videos about him way back in the day, at least two that I know of, maybe more, because I definitely do remember this guy. The original video I made got deleted, and I tried to find it. I can't find it, but I do still have an update video up that I uploaded in 2017. And in that video, it says I first made a video about this guy in March of 2016. So this is a throwback from over 8 years ago, and I do happen to have one small clip from the original video. So this might help you remember who exactly this guy is if you've seen it.
Hold on.
Can I get an image of your butt? Can I get an image of your butt?
Dude, what kind of weird.
Yeah, so if you have seen the originals, just off that alone, I think that should refresh your memory because I totally remember what this guy used to do. He used to upload videos on YouTube and he would just like go around and like just harass every single woman on the street and just go up to him and start saying weird stuff like that. Just a total freak. So I remember I found those back in the day and I made a couple of videos on this guy and we were just like laughing at him because he was so insane. And then later on, it turns out that this guy actually got arrested, unsurprisingly, I guess, for being an actual predator.
A Bay Area community is reacting tonight to a man who once called himself the downtown LA predator. He's now living in their neighborhood. Daniel Patrick Cilley is a high-risk sex offender who has moved to Rohnert Park.
Daniel Cilley, the downtown LA predator. Doc might have some competition. He might need to watch out for this guy. But anyways, let's fast forward about 8 years to our current time. Okay, we know the history of Daniel over here, but unfortunately, the account has been suspended now on Twitter, which is kind of shocking to me because nowadays on Twitter, I feel like you can pretty much post anything you want and it's good to go. I see like so much terrible stuff all the time. So I'm actually really surprised that this guy's account got taken down. But I do have some screenshots of all the original tweets and stuff. So here is the original tweet that he posted. I'm not gonna read it out. You can see that he's on some really weird stuff. I'm not reading that out. But if you look at the name of the account, it says Daniel P. Silly, the name that news anchor just said was Daniel Patrick Silly, right? And on top of that, he got community noted that he is indeed a registered sex offender, and then they pulled up his records and everything and has a picture and like, listen, I don't want to say it's 100%. Barely anything in life is 100% guaranteed. But I would say in this situation, based off everything that I just looked at and that we just went over, I would say probably a 99.99% chance that this is the same guy. I'm just gonna assume that it is. You know what I mean? I'm gonna put the side-by-side comparison up. It's definitely been a rough 8 years for this guy. I mean, originally it wasn't that bad, I would say, but now he kind of looks like a crackhead. Times have definitely changed, but one thing has not changed, as we can see. He is still a certified freak. I don't really have much to add as far as that discussion goes. I think we can see that. Honestly, it's just more shocking to me that this guy's still around, you know? He truly is dedicated. Now, unfortunately, he's dedicated to being a weirdo. You know, it would be better off if he, you know, pushed this dedication and this passion towards something positive. You know, maybe he could be doing big things. But instead, he decided to be a freak. It is what it is. It was just so weird to me when I saw this on Twitter because, like, I originally saw the retweet, or I guess the quote tweet of his, like, arrest record. They're like, oh, this guy's a predator or whatever. I was like, that's weird. So then I clicked on what the original tweet was to see, like, what the, you know, the person was talking about. And then I seen the post. I read the name of the account. It was like Daniel P. Silly or whatever. And then I went back to the quote tweet. I looked at the mugshot and I read the name and I was like, hold on, man. I think I know this guy. I'm like, this shit sounds hella familiar. Hold on. Then I went to my YouTube and I scrolled back and I clicked on a bunch of videos until I found it. And I was like, hold on. This is the same fucking guy, bro. Like, that's insane. It's just a crazy coincidence. You know, sometimes I forget how long I really been out here making videos. You know, I've seen so many wild things over the years. Like, just the fact that I was talking about this guy, you know, 8, almost 9 years ago, and now, like, he's back here again, and new people are talking about him. Like, look at this weirdo. Like, that's so crazy. So that's pretty much it for the video. I don't really have too much to say. I just thought it was kind of interesting. So I just wanted to show you guys this, especially for those of you who remember this guy. The update video I made on this guy in 2017 has 450,000 views, so I'm not sure how much the original video had. I'm sure it had a lot as well, so I'm thinking some of you may actually remember this guy. Because when I posted on Twitter, a lot of people were in the replies like, yo, I remember this guy, that's hilarious, like, that's so crazy, you know what I mean? So I thought I would do a YouTube update as well, because it was just such an insane, like, coincidence to see that, you know what I mean? But yeah, anyways, that's pretty much it for the video, man. Black Ops 6 beta dropping next week, COD next. Next week, I'll definitely be streaming COD next. I think it's at like noon on like Thursday or something. I don't know the exact date. I'll definitely be streaming that, and I'll definitely be streaming the beta next weekend as well. Call of Duty season is coming. We'll see how this game is. I don't know. I don't really have too much thoughts on it yet, because it's just the movement is so different from anything that we've ever played that it, like, I feel like you need to play it to really give an opinion on this one. So we'll be finding out pretty soon, but I'm definitely looking forward to getting my hands on that. But yeah, other than that, thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to like, rating if you enjoyed. Subscribe if you're not already. Follow me on Twitter, links in the description down below. Check out my last video if you missed it. It was about the whole H2M Modern Warfare 2 remastered situation. Also, I seen some people still like downloading some files for that, like the unofficial, like, you know, just people just going in like Discord and downloading a random file that has the game. I would just advise you not to do that, you know what I mean? Or if you are gonna do that, I would advise you to at least tape up your webcam, because they're gonna be watching you jerk off. So I mean, it's a kind of a trade-off there, you know. Maybe you get to play the game. Maybe some 50-year-old man's going to be watching you through your webcam. You never know. But anyways, just some advice. Be careful with that. Other than that, once again, thank you guys so much for watching. Have a good day and peace out.